The Bible talks about African slaves being bound in chains and taken from their country. In history, the white people who oppressed the slaves, raped the slaves, killed them, tortured them, and do all manners of evil to them, and treat them as dogs, they came up with this concept because they believed the Bible, supposedly. And this concept they came up with is called once saved, always saved. But is that the character of God? If you want to understand the Bible, all you need to know is to look at the characteristics of God throughout the world. What did God do when people act a certain way? What will happen if everyone believes that? What is the outcome? Is it a godly outcome? If you believe that you can do whatever you want and you're still straight, what is the outcome at the end of the day? So if they know they can do whatever they want and get away with it, what is stopping them from doing all the sins? The Bible says man is born in sin, shape of iniquity. For necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me. I preach not the gospel. Woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. This is the man who got beaten with many stripes, shipwrecked, bitten with a rattlesnake, thrown in a pot of boiling oil, thrown in prison, slapped in his face, spit in his face, being persecuted by his own people. Once you get saved, you're straight, but God still punish you in his life. But how can that be true if this man is going through all his hands right now? And he's not going through because of the hand of God. He's going through because of persecution. Then he which had received one talent came and said, Lord, I knew thee. The second afternoon, Lord, I knew thee. And I was afraid. And went and hid thy talent in the earth. No, there is your talent. His Lord said and answered unto him, thou wicked and slothful servant, thou knew it. So those who are saved and don't do right are even worse punishment than those who do. It's when you say the better stay in the word of God, or else it'll be worse for you. That's a complete opposite. He said, you know better. You know me. Yet you allow your fear to force you not to sow. And cast thee, the unprofitable servant, into outer darkness. What is outer darkness? Here was just the second death in Revelation. Outer darkness, there shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is not the first time Jesus said weeping and gnashing of teeth. Every time Jesus talks about hell, he speaks about weeping and gnashing of teeth. Do you think God is a waste of words? Would Jesus say all of this just meaninglessly? Isn't he trying to make a point here? That if you are a Christian and you do nothing for God, you go into hell? Isn't this clear? If this is so clear as day, why do people believe that they can do whatever they want to do and God will still let them come in? It's a lie in the pits of hell. We're going to your own salvation with fear and trembling. So you go fear them. What is there to fear and trembling? If there is no punishment.